What is up, my friends? Game of Thrones season 8, the final season. It will have 6 episodes total. We just got through the first one, Winterfell, and totally was setup after setup after setup. And that's the way it's gotta be. I mean, come on, this is the final season. This is 2 years in the making, and we're definitely gonna get something very, very special. And pretty excited to see how that all comes to play. Now, this show came out in 2011. We're now in 2019. It's been a long time coming. But pretty much what we saw season 8 go about is many reunions and many, many people upset with Jon for giving up the crown to follow Dany. Now, Dany, of course, as we see in the episode, is not trusted in the North at all, especially Sansa. She is not doing anything with Dany. She looks like she's had it. And, I mean, Sophie Turner is just pretty much looking more pissed than what she's going to look when X-Men Dark Phoenix comes out, because that's another story, another video. Anyways, let's talk about also the fact that Jon and Dany got to ride dragons together. Jon for the first time riding the dragon. Absolutely breathtaking. Game of Thrones really stepping up the season with the quality, the look of the whole show. And definitely proving that television is in its golden age still. This should be a sign to Jon Snow that I'm not just Jon Snow, I'm a Targaryen. So anyways, we do know that from season 7, shit hits the fan with that also this season. Before we get into that, let's talk about else what happened in this episode 1 that I call it the setup episode. As I said, we find out, we already knew this, but Samwell finds out that his father and even his brother, which is the one that hits Samwell even more than his father, were actually killed by Daenerys for not bending at the knee. He's feeling a little bit overwhelmed about all of this, and this leads him to say, "Jon, you are a Targaryen, and you are just like the rightful king." And this has Jon conflicted, because on one side he has Samwell, who which is like his brother, best mate, you could say. And then you have Dany, who he's in love with. Relationship with both of them, doesn't want to lose either of them. But finding out the truth about his father and his mother, also what happened with Samwell's family, you pretty much see that he is in a really weird predicament where he is like stuck and doesn't know where to move, because he'll lose one or the other and has to make a decision pretty quick, because things are heating up. Because we also see the Night King leaving a really creepy message and leaving us down that road that is like horror-esque, because that thing was just creepy, leaving a spiral symbol as well. And then the end of the premiere saw us Jaime and Bran lock eyes in the end, and Jaime's probably thinking, "The things I did for love." So we're supposed to be getting a big battle in episode 3 from the sounds of it. So I'm pretty sure that episode 2 is just going to be a little bit more of a setup. And then finally shit's going to hit the fan by the end of episode 2. But I really wonder what's going to happen between Jaime and Bran. It's just one of those things that brings you back to season 1. Which I think that the show did marvelously. So kudos to them for that. But anyways, what do you think is going to be happening? Are you excited? Are you not? Did you enjoy the first episode? Did you expect more? I thought that they were going to be longer as well, the episodes, especially with 6 episodes to wrap up a whole 8 seasons. It just sounds insane. Let me know what you think, though. What do you think is going to happen with Dany and Jon? What do you think is going to happen with Jaime and Bran? What do you think is going to happen with Cersei? All of that in the comments below. I'll be making more talking about the teaser as well tomorrow that got released for episode 2, and you can check out more from me talking about Game of Thrones by subscribing below, liking, commenting, share, all that good stuff. I'll see y'all next time. 7,000 subscribers, let's get to it. Stay positive.